We're just going to take you briefly to New York now. The Israeli ambassador to the United Nations has taken some questions. Let's just listen in for a moment.
So we will decide about when and how we will respond, but I can tell you one thing. It will be noticed. It will be painful. And I think that the people of Iran who are watching us understand that it's not against the Iranian people, it's against the radical regime that dragged the Iranian people into this situation.
Thank you. Gabriel Elizondo from Al Jazeera English. Ambassador, at the very podium that you're at now just a few days ago, Ayman Safadi, the foreign minister of Jordan, stood at the very podium there and he said, on behalf of 57 Arab and Muslim countries, they are willing to provide safety or help provide safety to Israel, safety and security to Israel, your country, if for long-term should I go ahead?
Yeah.
If Israel ends their occupation and really pursues an independent state for the Palestinian people, they are willing to work with you towards peace. And he said from that podium, ask any Israeli official, what is their long-term plan for peace other than what you're doing in Lebanon and what's happening in Gaza? So I ask you, sir, what is Israel's long-term plan for peace?
I appreciate the sincerity of the Minister of Foreign Affairs, and we have a peace treaty with Jordan. But when you look at what's happening today in our neighborhood, attacks from Lebanon, attacks from Yemen, attacks from Iran, every Israeli asks himself today, who is my partner?
Okay, we'll leave that there because we've got a bit to get to.